Hey, what is up? We got another BO4 update. So we got some new features added to Blackout, multiplayer, and zombies. So first up is Blackout. Now this is first on PlayStation 4, but don't get too angry, Xbox and PC people, because it's kind of weird and it's not all that great. So let's get into what it is. So this is the new Blackout camo progression system. Paint can resource system and full weapon camo progression has been added to Blackout. Players collect paint cans throughout the world in each match. You bank them and cash them in to unlock weapon camos. Weapon camo variants have been added to Blackout, and mastery camo, gold to diamond and dark matter support added to Blackout. That's what you wanted, right? Well, they implemented it in such a weird way. Let's go to the armory. And so let's just pick, let's see, I was working on the sniper earlier. Let's take the paladin. So you notice in the top left, I have 13 paint cans, and I've been collecting paint cans in Blackout. That just sounds so weird. And you bank these paint cans to unlock these camos. There's really no skill involved, no real challenges, just collecting cans. Yes, and then you redeem them to get the new camo. So here's Coral Panther, and I redeemed 10 cans that I've collected, and now I get to have this camo. Now the camos are pretty cool, and you know, hey, this is great for people like, hey, look at that blue tiger, that looks nice, huh? And this is great for people who, you know, they don't really play much Blackout, they're not that great. You know, Blackout is slightly more difficult than multiplayer. And then once you unlock all of that, then you collect even more cans to get these camos. And then that is how you get gold, diamond, and eventually dark matter. You can get dark matter without ever firing your weapon in Blackout. So, but the thing is though, if you get dark matter here, you cannot use it in multiplayer or zombies. And if you notice, I'm scrolling through multiplayer and zombies, the multiplayer, you cannot use that dark matter there because the Blackout version is, you gotta collect cans. It's so weird. I'm not sure what to think of it. Same for zombies, and we'll get more into zombies. And reactive camo. Now, if you wanna use a reactive camo, and it's like this in zombies also, you got to complete these challenges. So if I wanna get plasma drive on my pally, I need to unlock gold on this weapon. And as you saw, the way you unlock gold is by collecting cans. So how many cans in total? So this is from a Reddit user, Bag of Donuts, and he calculated it. You need 270 cans to unlock gold. So there's 7 ARs, that's 1,890 for diamond on there. 1,890 for diamond on the SMGs. You can see it's over 1,000 for the tac rifles, the LMGs, the snipers, the two shotguns is 540 to get diamond there. The four pistols is a grand, and the launcher is 270. So you get diamond on everything, and then you get dark matter. And Donuts calculated almost 9,000 cans for dark matter. What this reminds me of is when Zero came first, the new specialist, when she came first to play PS4, Xbox people and PC, you guys were a little upset about it. But the version we got, the beta version, she was so overpowered and really annoying. And a week later, when you guys got it, she was a lot more civilized. And then they ended up nerfing her even further. And that's what I think when I see this. I think they may have the amount of cans you have to collect. It's such a weird system. They may actually add challenges. I want to feel like I earned something. Here, you're just like, oh, hey, there's a can. I found it. And all it's saying is, yep, I played a lot of this game. Or I didn't play the game at all. I just ran around collecting cans. It's, I don't know. It feels very rushed. It's such an odd system. What do you guys think about it? All right, other minor thing they added, go to character, head to Zero, and you see that she has an outfit mission, and that's the numbers outfit. So let's go ahead and check out her outfits, scroll down to the numbers, and it's the new orange. Well, there is some parts of it that are red and black, but for the most part, it is now orange and black, and that was because people were team killing each other. They did, they would think you're an enemy. The way you get it, I have marked it here on the map. You can see you go to these offices that are right above Hydro Dam. Head over to the computers, All right, so it's up in this room next to the computers, and it's called the Alien Charm. It's a little keychain. Destroy 50 equipment in your lifetime. So in my case, I'm more than halfway there. I've destroyed 27 pieces of equipment. So the trophy system, that's gonna be very valuable. Be sure to pick up a trophy system, put it on your vehicle, or you know, just use it in general to destroy the grenades and stuff, shoot down the sensor darts, things like that. So once you know that you have 50 destroyed, then head over here, collect it, and then just finish the match. You don't have to win. You don't have to do anything special. Just hold on to it, finish the game, and there you go. Get Numbers outfit. So not really difficult. It just requires you to kind of play the game and, take those trophy systems more often. All right, multiplayer. They have added the Pro Series Mosh Pit. This is to hold us over for league play. League play is gonna come out in about 2-3 weeks, and this is sort of a placeholder for it. So Pro Series Mosh Pit, here are the rules. I will also have the rules in the description. It's the exact rules that the pros use. The modes are Hardpoint, Control, Search and Destroy. Friendly Fire is enabled, all right? So if you kill a teammate, even when he's weak, you will get kicked. So just like how the pros play, restricted specialists, Ajax, Nomad, Torque, and Zero are all banned. Restricted specialist equipment, the Seeker Drone, Reactor Core, Tac Deploy, all banned. So when you use those characters, you need to have a stun or a trophy system, something else on your character, on your class. The restricted weapons are the Titan, Hades, VKM, the MOG 12, SU-12, the SWAT, Daemon, and the Cap. Restricted attachments, High Cal, Rapid, Steady Grip, Laser Sight 2, Max Load, Rocket Cash, High Explosive, and Fast Lock. Restricted perks, Gung Ho, which kind of sucks, but I understand it, Skulker, Team Link, and Tracker, and restricted score streaks, Dart, RC, UAV, Care Pack, Counter UAV, Sentry, and Mantis. Restricted wildcards, Overkill, Primary and Secondary Operator Mod, and restricted gear is Acoustic Sensor. So that is basically all the beginner streaks. And so you'll probably want to make a setup that has Lightning Strike, Hellstorm, Drone Squad, because those are the first three. You're more than welcome to go higher than that, but it is competitive and there's going to be a lot of sweaty people. As far as a class, I can give you guys some suggestions to work with. It seems like the two main weapons right now at the time of this recording are the SOG for the SMGs. And for the assault rifles, a lot of people tend to use it's either a toss-up between the ICR or Maddox. Those are the main ones. I'm more of an SMG guy, so a class setup that you guys could try using is Quick Draw. I do prefer Grip, and Stock is actually really, really good. And it seems like the must-have is Stim Shot, just because, you know, everyone's a little bit better. Everyone's really trying. And then again, because someone may take a character that you really want, you should have a class that has concussions on there. And the one that I really have to get used to is just not having Gung Ho. Gung Ho makes the game, you know, kind of easy. You can reload while running. You can hold your stun while running. So that is why it's been removed. It kind of takes away from skill. So instead, you will need to have Dexterity. And you can have Tac Mask or Engineer. They're both pretty good. Engineer will help you spot the trophy systems for your team, and there is search, so you should have a search setup that has dead silence on it. Up next is Zombies. Trek has added mastery camos, gold, diamond, dark matter to zombies on all platforms, as well as support for mastercrafts, reactive camos, and black market camos. You will be able to track your progress as you complete challenges in the armory on your way to earning mastery camos. So let's check that out right now. And let's just, we'll go over the ICR and go to personalize. And the first challenges here are 3,600 headshots. So yeah, this is more for the hardcore zombie players. And they, after you do that, you complete your technical challenges, which are probably more headshots, more kills. And then you can get gold, diamond, and then finally dark matter. So you can't use your dark matter from multiplayer. You can't use your dark matter from blackout. It's its own unique, well, not unique version. It's its own version that you must unlock here. Heading over to the black market. Same goes for reactive camos. You cannot use these reactive camos unless you complete the challenges inside zombies. So it's very much just like the blackout version, except not as dumb where you have to collect things. So yeah, that's a little weird. You notice though, when I highlight the blackout section, you can use the cans. You have that there. It shows you how many cans I have and how to unlock it. So I don't have enough cans right here to unlock this, so I can't do it, but there you go. It's a better than the blackout version. Other thing is, let's click on this, the reflex. And there's challenges for reflex and red dots and elos. To get this red dot plus, it's get 500 kills while aiming down the sights. So no headshots or anything, just keep doing what you're doing. Keep shooting zombies with that reticle. And it's the same for pretty much all the other guns. All right guys, some small stuff added, pretty cool things. What do you guys think of that blackout collecting cans thing? I don't know. I don't know about that. I was hoping for some actual challenges, but there you go. It rewards the players, I guess, that's all they do is play blackout. And they don't really have to do much. Just pick up the cans, requires no skill at all. Whereas, you know, with multiplayer, you know, those, I feel like those do require some amount of skill and some patience. So links to all the stuff down below. And again, if you want to come hang out on the stream, come play, link to my Twitch down below. On the left side there is the Epic Moments playlist, and the right, a brand new video.